I'm Luc de Rademaker. I'm the director and co-founder of Brussels Beer Challenge. And today we are celebrating our 10th edition. We started in Brussels like in 2012. It was actually in the mandate of the City Council of Brussels. Can you do something around beer? Because my two business partners, Baudelaire Vaux and Thomas Costanoble, they have like the biggest wine competition in the world, Concours Mondial, behind Brussels. And Brussels City Council asked, can you do something around beer? Those guys know a lot about organizing an event, they know a lot about wine, but their beer knowledge was a little, let's say, low. So I came in the picture, and together we founded the Brussels Beer Challenge. We started 10 years ago in Brussels with like 500 beers and around 40 judges. Now we are 1,800 beers and 75 judges from like 40 countries around the world. And the beers are coming from also from 49 countries around the world. So it was quite a journey. We have like three goals. First of all, do a professional fair competition. Secondly, it's more marketing for the consumer to have like a label that you know, you see Brussels Beer Challenge label on a bottle, the beer will be high quality. If you will like the beer, depending on your taste, but the quality will be good. For the producer, if you win, of course, you can use it for marketing. And the third, and that's for me maybe the most important, is to defend beer culture in general and Belgian beer culture in special. And what we're trying to do, we only normally the all competitions around the world, we taste all day, from 9 o'clock in the morning to 4 o'clock in the afternoon. We only do it in the morning. The reason is, okay, it's more fun for the judges, but also we like to show, we are quite proud on our beers, on our country, we like to show the judges Belgium. What's Belgium? What's Belgium beer? What's Belgium beer culture? And that's why we do always visits after tastings.
Over the past 10 years of the, you know, the competition, what can you say about Belgian beer evolving? What are the trends? We all know, of course, the great trend in Brussels and perhaps around.
Yeah, it's very difficult in the beginning. With like a few years, there was like a big like competition between Belgium and the United States. And we had like 3 years, like every newspaper was Americans had more medals than Belgian brewers. That's quite normal because Belgian brewers, they only enter their beers in like triple, wheat beer, double, blonde, traditional Belgium styles. And there we win medals. American brewers, they brew everything. They brew a triple, they brew Imperial Stout, they brew IPAs, they brew Kolsch, they brew everything. So of course, they have more chance to win. And then like the big media was like, oh, Americans beat Belgium on their own territory. It's not true, but of course, a newspaper has to sell. I know it works. And it was a big competition. Then it calmed down, and now we see like every year we have some trends. Now we have like a lot of NIPAs. Like NIPAs is coming up, like fruit beers are going over the top. But there is one big trend, and really the classic styles like Belgium style triple, Belgium style wheat beer, those are really the biggest categories in the Brussels Beer Challenge, and so for 10 years they're quite popular and brewers are sending the triples to the competition.
So the future looks quite good in terms of Belgian brewers.
It's my personal opinion, also apart from Brussels Beer Challenge and everything I do, like Belgian beer is about balance. Belgian beer is about like tradition, and like the Belgian family brewers, okay, they are not brewing like 500 beers in a year, they are brewing 3, 4, 5 beers, that's it. If they have a new beer, they think about it for years, they work it, they change one little detail, and it takes for 3 years before it's perfect. A craft brewer, he takes more risk. He will brew something, oh, that's nice, tomorrow, oh, I do something crazy. And for me, both, they're both good, and both have their values. But me personally, I like more like, okay, I'm Belgian, it's normal, the Belgian style about balance and tradition, and take a long time to think about the beer, and that's for me Belgium. And that's the Belgium, family brewers in general, or like the old traditional Belgian breweries.
Do you think the consolidation that's been hitting the industry and perhaps been accelerated by COVID or people looking for investments, will that harm Belgian beer and breweries?
Difficult to tell. For me, I think some breweries are in difficulties because, okay, they invested, COVID came, they are like delivering to the Orica, export. I think those people are in difficult times for them. Like other small craft breweries, they could deliver by bike or even by foot in their neighborhood. And people, pubs were closed, like you could not go to a concert. So what you do, you stay at your room and you buy locally. And those people, they did good business. So I heard different stories, like some brewers are saying, okay, pubs are closed, oh shit, I'm bankrupt. Other people, you know what, actually during lockdown, during COVID, it was good for my business. So you have two kinds of stories.
Does the future look bright for Belgian beer in general?
I think for beer in general, not only for Belgian beer, but I think more and more people, also young people, are convinced that beer is like a good beverage. It's even healthy if you, okay, don't drink too much, don't overdo it, but beer is in healthy lifestyle, beer is its place, and beer is also about friends, about fun, talking to each other, being social. Also can take a beer on your own, with a good book, like in your sofa, at the fireplace. I think beer is like, at the table with a nice dinner, like beer is like everywhere. I think people more, when I was young, you drank beer with your friends in the pub. If you go to a restaurant, you drank wine. Now you can drink wine in a pub, and you can drink beer in a three-star restaurant. So I think the future of beer will be bright.
Excellent. Thank you, Luke.
You're welcome.